Hi friends, in this video we will go to discuss about resonance. Most of the students have trouble in this topic. In this video I will go to say easy way of finding resonance and resonance circuit and what is resonance. Okay, first let's see what is resonance. If the applied frequency is equal to the natural frequency of the circuit, then the circuit is said to be resonance or resonance circuit. Here applied voltages and resulting currents are in phase. Okay, first, as per the definition, resonance is nothing but if applied frequency is equal to the natural frequency. If suppose in a circuit we apply some current source, it has some frequency. If that applied frequency is equal to the natural frequency is nothing but transient frequency. Whenever we are getting applied frequency equal to the natural frequency, then that circuit act as a resonance. Resonance simply says, resonance is nothing but when we will get maximum output. In which condition we will get maximum condition in a networks, that condition is nothing but resonance. And one more important point is nothing but resonance frequency. It is simply represented like FR. What is FR? It means at which frequency we are getting output is maximum, that frequency is nothing but resonance frequency. Here we have one more point. Here applied voltages and resulting currents are in phase. Means if we apply any voltage source to the network and we will get response in some other branches like current, in these applied voltages and that resulting currents are both in phase. Whenever our circuit is in resonance is nothing but whenever we are getting the high voltages or high outputs, high response, that is nothing but a resonance. Okay, let's move on the conditions for a resonance. Let's see conditions for resonance. Whenever we are calling a circuit is a resonance circuit, then it should satisfy some of the conditions. That conditions is nothing but XC or XL equal to XC. You know what is XL? XL is nothing but inductive reactance. And here XL is the inductive reactance and XC is the capacitive reactance. As I already told you in my previous videos, inductive reactance and capacitive reactance is nothing but the opposing nature of inductor and capacitor is nothing but a reactance. Okay, whenever we are getting this condition, that is XL equal to XC, then only we can call that is the resonance circuit. Okay, XL equal to XC is the total resonance circuit condition, one of the important condition. When you call the circuit as a resonance means whenever the inductive reactance equal to the capacitive reactance in that circuit, then that circuit is said to be resonance. And one more condition is there in resonance circuit. Here see, applied voltages and resulting currents are in phase. In phase means there is no phase difference. Phase is indicated as phi. There is no phase difference means phi value is 0. Okay, there is no phase difference means phi value is 0. This is about conditions for a resonance. Okay, here see, XL is the inductive reactance and XC is the capacitive reactance. We know how to find the total reactance of a circuit. The total reactance of a circuit is nothing but the difference between the inductor reactance and capacitor reactance, that is simply XL minus XC. Here from the resonance conditions we know XL equal to XC, that is nothing but if we have a resonance circuit, in the circuit inductive reactance is equal to the capacitive reactance, that is this both are same, then we resulting get as 0. Okay, I think you have understand. In resonance circuit, both inductive reactance equal to capacitor reactance. That means the total reactance equal to zero. Okay. This condition means the total reactance in the resonance circuit is equal to zero. Okay. Total reactance in the resonance circuit is equal to zero. See one more point. We know impedance Z equal to resistance plus reactance. We know in our previous video also we discussed impedance equal to resistance plus reactance. Here observe, reactance is zero because this inductive reactance and capacitor reactance both are same. Difference between these two reactances is zero. That means this complete term will become as zero and we will get Z equal to R. This is also one more condition in resonance circuits, that is impedance equal to the resistance. Whenever we having the resonance circuit, then it should satisfy these three conditions: capacitor reactance equal to inductive reactance, and the phase angle in between the input and output is zero, impedance equal to resistance. This is about conditions and resonance. In the next video, we will go to discuss about some more points on resonance. Thank you for watching this video.